I got the idea for the sequel when my daughter started kindergarten, and another parent said to me, just think, in 13 years, they'll be adults and they'll be gone. And I was like, what? What? You know, it was such a shocking feeling because it's been 13 years since we made number one. 13 years goes like that. And I knew it because I walk around with this face all the time, so people will say to me something about the first movie. It's been 13 years. So for someone to say that number, 13 years, they'll be gone. They'll be adults and they'll be in college. That's when I knew. First of all, I had the knowledge of what it's like to be a mother, and I could write about the emotions. And number two, I could write about all the angst of wanting to keep my daughter close, but knowing it's best for her to go. And as a Greek parent, I think as any parent knows, you can't hover. You have to let them go at some point. The thing I wanted to do when I set out to write the sequel is show the incredibly familiar theme to all of us in that we turn into our parents. Whether we like it or not, you become your own parents. I hear phrases coming out of my mouth to my daughter that it makes me crazy that I know now that I am now becoming my mom. You know, it's not a bad thing, but wow, all the things you thought you'd do differently, you don't. You are just a parent, and that's all you can do. I'm hoping to depict what happens in every marriage, I think, in that if you don't work on it and you don't have time, the romance can go. And I don't think it's a female thing. I think men want it too. I think we want those heady days of courtship and kisses in the car and all the things that made, you know, trying to lure each other just a really romantic experience. And of course it goes. Of course, it has to. You can't live in that state of overwhelm. Jobs, finances, kids' emotions, time in the house, all those things are a constant strain on a relationship. So I wanted to show that in a real, and I hope funny way. And then I also wanted to explore what it's like to see yourself in your own child and see yourself in your parents. Since the first movie came out and I had the benefit of getting to go to so many countries and just, you know, walking down the street, taking my daughters to school, just doing regular things, grocery shopping, and hearing what people loved about the movie, what surprises me over and over and over again is how everyone sees their family in this family. The ethnicity doesn't matter to people. They're not relating to a Greek family. In their minds, they're relating to a family. And that is really surprising to me. It's just what I call a happy accident. It was I thought I wrote about my family, and I found out I wrote about your family too. Oh, and yours, and yours, and yours. That surprised me. I hope that people see themselves reflected in this film again. I know that over the years, people have said to Andrea Martin, you're my favorite character, and have said to Lainey Kazan, you're my favorite character, or to Michael Constantine, you're my favorite character. What that means to me is that there is somebody in this film for everyone. Everyone relates to somebody in this film, and I like that. I like to write, as you know, I always say I'm a middle child from Winnipeg. You know, I just want everyone to be happy. You know, I just want everyone to say, oh, I'm in this movie.